Hello everybody, welcome to the Impressa channel. I wanted to do a video on the rise and the fall of the Pussycat Dolls. The Pussycat Dolls was a popular girl group that made a notable stamp in music between 2005 and 2010. The Pussycat Dolls had a pop-infused style, high-energy dance routines, and a sassy attitude that caught the attention of many. In some ways, the Pussycat Dolls mimicked the Spice Girls, but they had a more sultry and provocative edge. No one knew that this girl group would go on to sell 15 million records worldwide and 40 million singles, all in the course of 5 years. The Pussycat Dolls was first envisioned by the talented choreographer Robin Anton. In the 90s, Robin created a burlesque act that picked up a lot of buzz in the music scene. Sooner or later, the Pussycat Dolls was molded into a singing group and they were signed to Interscope Records. The group consisted of several dancers, which included Carmit Bachar, Ashley Roberts, Jessica Sutta, Kimberly Wyatt, and three singers, Melody Thornton. Jones, and Nicole Scherzinger. Nicole was already in a previous girl group called Eden's Crush, and she was brought in the Pussycat Dolls to be the lead singer. I'm singing 'cause you're so, so into me. Little did we know, Nicole was actually responsible for all the group's vocals, including backup vocals.
I was in center because I was singing. I was the one singing.
Nicole said that she actually sang 95% of the songs.
I probably did 95% of the album on my own.
However, one of the former members of a group named Kaya Jones claimed that Nicole sang most of the songs because she refused to share the spotlight. She said Nicole was always someone who wanted to be in the spotlight and would pretty much do anything to get it. Kaya Jones was also disappointed at the emphasis that was placed on Nicole, which is the reason why she left the group prematurely. This allowed Carmit to step in her place as singer, and Nicole, Carmit, and Melody became the vocal backbone of the Pussycat Dolls.
Like a lazy ocean hugs the shore, hold me close, sway me more, sway me, make me,
hey, yeah.
Fill me, hold me. Have a way with me.
The extra focus on Nicole turned her into a diva and caused some stress on the group behind the scenes. However, Nicole's undeniable star quality propelled the group to superstardom. The Pussycat Dolls released their first album in 2005, which produced cocky hits like Don't Ya and sexy anthems like Buttons. Don't you wish your girlfriend was hot like me? The group was a groundbreaking success and a popular touring act, and they even opened up for artists like Britney Spears. The Pussycat Dolls' second album, Doll Domination, spawned several hits, including When I Grow Up and more. However, behind the scenes, the drama was getting ugly. Nicole received special treatment in the group because she was favored by the label executives and she had her own personal manager looking out for her. Plus, she demanded total control over the spotlight. It was clear to the other girls that Nicole was the only one who mattered. One of the group members, Carmit Bachar, actually exposed what was happening in the group. She said, "I think Nicole got it into her head that she was the real star and would be better off on her own. She started traveling in her own tour bus, and the divide between her and the rest of us got bigger." She also spoke on Nicole's jealousy of one of the group members named Ashley Roberts. She says, "She always had a thing about blonde girls. Ashley knew that Nicole was jealous of her and it made her feel uncomfortable. It was a hideous undertone in the group." Ashley said herself that she was silent and she wasn't allowed to talk in the group. Also, she said, "In the studio, my voice just closed up. During my time in the Dolls, I was told that I shouldn't sing, that I wasn't allowed, and I suppose that had an impact on me."
I love Nicole to pieces, but she's, you know, she's intense.
And even in the group, I wasn't allowed to talk.
Really? It's amazing.
Yeah, we were told to be quiet. Did that not drive you nuts? Are you serious? Why do you think the band broke up?
I think that we all wanted to have a voice for ourselves.
Kimberly Wyatt also spoke up about not being able to sing. She said, "It's not true at all that only one of us can sing. Everyone in the group has a beautiful voice. We just weren't showcased as much." Kimberly also said that, "I've been a Pussycat Doll for longer. She was one of the last to join, but we'd have to share a dressing room while Nicole would have her own. We'd be on the tour bus together, but she wouldn't come on and would get her own transport. I'm closer with the other girls because of the system that was in place." Carmit revealed that Nicole basically wanted to be front and center all the time. "We were expected to work our tails off to boost Nicole and her own career. The situation became unbearable." And this was the same sentiments that Kaya Jones actually expressed, which is the reason why she left the group.
There's Diva's Live footage and I'm on it. There's footage and I'm on it. So would I join and make money for somebody who never is even gonna admit that I was a part of the team? No.
How come it never morphed into some of the other girls singing as well on, well, they did on the albums, but they had their own songs, but they never really traded parts.
People get it mixed up sometimes. Everyone has an important role, but you just can't get it switched up. Do you know what I mean?
Carmit was the second one to walk away from the group, and one of the group members, Jessica, actually pretended to be her by wearing her signature red hair. It almost seems like some of the ladies in the group were actually being ungrateful for complaining, especially because Nicole was the reason why the group was such a big success. However, they had some reason for their dismay. For one, Nicole was secretly planning to go solo behind their back. Nicole and her team secretly plotted to have her do solo projects and recordings, hence her releasing her singles Baby Love and Whatever You Like. The group also dealt with financial issues. Even though the girls were touring and selling millions of records, they weren't seeing the desired profits. Nicole was paid more, while the other girls were paid much less. This was due to the fact that Nicole sang most of the records, but also the group's profits were eaten up by the expensive demos that Nicole was doing.
But last year, after 7 years with the group, Jessica says she went from the Hollywood high life to nearly becoming homeless.
Did you make any money out of it?
No, not a whole lot.
Not a whole lot.
No,
I definitely felt like a glorified backup dancer. Nicole was the front and center. She was a lead singer and everything went around her.
The tension behind the scenes ended up spilling onto the stage. One of the members, Melody Thornton, had an emotional moment on stage exposing deeper issues that the ladies were facing in the group.
You can do anything you want to do. And anything you want to do.
you and the girls, there was some animosity there.
Sweetie, it's just inevitable. You just, things are gonna clash and things are gonna happen.
What was the biggest clashes over? Jealousy? That you were the singer?
I think it's just inevitable.
Nicole had her own management. She had someone to look after her. It wasn't about us.
Despite Nicole's alleged diva antics, no one knew the amount of pressure she was dealing with. The label put a heavy responsibility on her to carry the group. Also, Nicole had a terrible eating disorder called bulimia, which caused her to be very irritable. The pressure of being in the group became too much for Nicole sometimes, but it also became too much for the girls, to the point where they all walked away.
But as for why she left the life of privilege behind, Jess admits, I felt like it was time to not live in the shadow of Nicole. It wasn't a joyful experience.
You guys have split up.
Yeah, a couple of girls have left the group.
And why did you let them do that?
I mean, I don't control them.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
The group officially broke up in 2010 due to unfair politics behind the scenes. Nicole was the only one left standing, and the label thought it would be easy to replace her ex-bandmates with different backup dancers. However, fans were already familiarized with the group members, and the replacement would be too obvious. Instead of building another group around Nicole, Nicole and her team decided to push her as a solo artist. Nicole had a decent amount of success, and she had a few hits under her belt. Come here, baby, hey, be my baby, hey, be my baby, oh, oh, oh. And I'm gonna make you feel good. Oh. However, Nicole's solo efforts did not make the same impact as her efforts in the Pussycat Dolls. Nicole continued to work hard on other projects. Also, the other ladies continued to work on their own solo projects, and some of them even returned to their first love, which was dance. Despite the drama, luckily all the ladies in the Pussycat Dolls made up with Nicole, and they seem to be in a good place with each other. They have grown up and accomplished so much together and separately. Their impact has set the tone for other girl groups like Girlicious, Danity Kane, and Fifth Harmony. I wouldn't be surprised if the Pussycat Dolls reunited one day. The future looks promising. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching this brief documentary, and I'll see you next time.